Hello everyone and welcome back to Licklibrary. My name is Leigh Fuge and in this video today we're going to be checking out the guitar style and habits of Iron Maiden guitar player Adrian Smith. In this video we're going to check out some of Adrian's key habits and stylistic features that you can take away and use in your own playing. As part of this lesson I've prepared a guitar solo in the style of Adrian Smith, so we're going to talk about some of the habits from that solo. We're also going to talk about Adrian's approach to harmony, as Iron Maiden use a lot of twin guitar harmony lines. If you'd like to check out the guitar styles of the other Iron Maiden guitar players, Dave Murray and Yannick Gurs, there's some links down below in the description and in the top corner of this video where you can check out those videos. All the sections of this video are timestamped down below, so you can go check those out and head over to your favorite section right away. So let's get straight into it. So before we check out the guitar solo that I've prepared, I want to talk to you a little bit about Adrian's approach to harmony. So there is, in the track that I've prepared, a twin guitar harmony section, and it sounds like this. So this track is in the key of E minor. Adrian is actually playing the lower harmony here, which is actually a minor third harmony of the root line, which starts from the root note of E. This is the line that's been played in the Dave Murray style video, so if you want to learn that line, go check that video out. So what Adrian is doing, which is quite unusual, is he's actually playing the minor third below the root note. Usually if we're playing our root note, let's say it's E in this case, a minor third, which is three semitones above, would be a G. So typically we'd start the second harmony from here. But what Adrian does is he actually comes down to this G. So we're sort of working in sixths here, with the minor third harmony a sixth below the root. This is quite an interesting take on harmony because it gives it a slightly different texture. It also gives that low end reinforcement as well. So the Adrian Smith harmony is this. So this is entirely centered around the A and D strings. We're starting with a slide from the 9 to the 10 on the A. Now this is just to push us into that G note. So we're not actually sounding this F sharp note as such, we're just using it to get to the G. And then we're playing A, B, and C, which is 7, 9, 10 on the D string. Then we're doing a pull off from the B to the A, and playing the B again. And then back to that G and F sharp. We've got that little turn there where we're playing the A, the G, the F sharp, and the G. So that's the first half. That sits perfectly with the harmony that's taught in the Dave Murray video. The second half of this harmony is the same sort of theme, but we're changing the ending slightly. So we've got that little rundown there where we're coming up to this D note, and we're playing the D with the C note. Notice I'm doing a pull off on the first note there, you can pick every note if you want. C and B, B and A, and then F sharp to G. So here's that harmony line in full played slow. And then once more, full speed. So those twin guitar lines, as I said, are a big component in the Iron Maiden guitar sound. Whether you're going for the Adrian Smith vibe, where you're going to play that minor third below the root line, or whether you want to stick to the root lines like Dave Murray, you can do that, but you do have to familiarize yourself with the concept of guitar harmonies if you want to get that Iron Maiden style sound. So all the remaining habits in this video we're going to talk about are based upon this Adrian Smith style guitar solo that I've put together for you. So the guitar solo sounds like this. So the first habit we can take from this solo is Adrian's use of melodic themes. Now you'll notice the guitar solo starts with a line that's very similar to the harmony that we played at the start of the video. This is actually just played in the root line now, so we're starting from the root note, but we're actually playing in an octave lower. So I'm actually starting from this E note here. I'm integrating some whammy bar action here because Adrian was a big user of the whammy bar. Once you've played that once, we've established the melodic theme. It's already a theme we've heard in the song already. Now we're just using it in the guitar solo. Then we're going to take it up an octave. This is a great habit to use because what this does is it reinforces a hook or a strong melody in a song. Adrian particularly is the melodic player in Maiden. A lot of what he does is very thought out and very meticulous. He always likes to lean upon themes in his guitar solos, and there are always sections that you can sing along to. This is a great habit to take away and put into your own playing, because if your song has a strong hook or a strong line that can be sung, you can put that into your guitar solo and take it to another level. The second Adrian Smith style habit we can take away from that guitar solo is his use of the whammy bar. Now this can be used for two main purposes in Adrian Smith's typical sort of trick box, one of which is kind of some extreme vibrato. And you saw me do a little bit of this at the start of the guitar solo. Where I'm almost using the bar there just to get some vibrato sounds out of the note. Wherever I hold that note, I can do some extreme vibrato. That also applies if I'm playing a lick, for instance, and I land on a note. I can bounce the bar in time there to get some really wide vibrato. It's actually going the opposite way though. So usually when we do pitch vibrato, we're increasing the pitch. With the whammy bar, we're going the other way. Kind of going down with the pitch. That is a very typical Adrian Smith idea. The other thing you'll see Adrian do with the whammy bar in Iron Maiden is dip the bar as he plays certain notes. So let's say you're playing this lick. Adrian's approach with the whammy bar would dip the bar on some of those notes and it would sound like this. So that gives the lick a very different flavor. So here's that slowly. You can see the points there where I'm dipping the bar. This is the technique he used a lot in the 1980s era especially. You don't tend to see Adrian using this too much in modern Maiden guitar solos, but if you look back to the 80s heyday, you'll see those whammy bar tricks all over the solos. The third Adrian Smith habit we can take away from that guitar solo is his use of repeated licks. So kind of like a melodic theme, a repeated idea in a solo is a great way to basically extend a passage that you're playing. If you're playing a bunch of notes in succession, it can be a great way to get a nice burst of speed as well. The lick you heard me playing that solo was similar to this. So what I'm actually doing there is I'm actually playing the same thing over and over again. I'm working in this pattern here that sits at the top of minor pentatonic scale shape 2 and extends up to shape 3. I'm playing a series of pull-offs between the 17 and 15 and the 19 and 15 on the high E string. I'm also playing the 17 on the B and the 15 on the E. You can use this kind of idea all over the fretboard to get different repeated licks. Whatever you're playing, you can apply that principle. It's a great way, like I said, to get some speed. If you're playing something that can be looped like that, you can actually push the speed again as long as the tempo that you're playing allows for it. You can get pretty fast to that, and it's a great way, like I said, to add a great burst of speed in the middle of a guitar solo without needing to run all over the fretboard. Also reinforces repetition and familiarity. So you can actually take a kind of melodic idea without it being a set melody and put that in your solo as a repeated idea. It's something for the listener to hook onto. The final Adrian Smith style habit we're going to check out is his use of bluesy phrasing. Now, even though Iron Maiden are a metal band, these guys brought up on 70s classic rock. So it's quite hard to escape your bluesy pentatonic based phrasing. So there's a lick in the guitar solo that I want to focus on, which sits in the E minor pentatonic scale. And this is the lick that I'm going to talk about. So this lick is essentially just a typical bluesy rock lick. I did actually throw in some whammy bar use at the end there to reinforce some of the other points as well. Once again, this is something Adrian did a lot in the 80s. It's very bluesy at its core, but then you can kind of take it off other places with different note choices. So what we're doing is this very, very typical repeated minor pentatonic rock lick, starting with a bend on the 14th fret of the G, up a full step. Then we're running down the scale, 12 on the high E, 15 and 12 on the B. You can pick those or you can do it as a pull-off. Then the second part of the lick is the same thing, but we're substituting the 14 on the G for the 15 on the B. The descending run here is exactly the same. We're just doing the bend on the 15 of the B now. So we've got 14 on the G, 15 on the B. So it's the same idea, but we can just repeat it. Then you can really start to build the speed up. And then all of a sudden we're straight into fast rock territory, but it still retains that bluesy feel. In the solo that I made, I ended that lick with a natural minor phrase. So we stepped just outside the pentatonic scale a little bit. I added this two note here, which is the 14th fret of the E string, which I'm bending up to the G, which is the minor third. And then I'm landing on this note here, which is the flat 6. This is what gives it a slightly unusual ending sound, but it's a very interesting note for rock and bluesy playing. And then digging in with that whammy bar once more. So here's that lick slowly. And then full speed. A great fun rock lick to put into your guitar solos. Thank you all so much for watching this video on the guitar style and habits of Iron Maiden's Adrian Smith. I hope you've all enjoyed this video, and I hope you've learned a few things, and I hope some of these ideas you've taken away and put into your own playing and got a little bit of that Adrian Smith vibe in your own playing as well. Let us know down below in the comments how you got on with that. And also let us know if there are any other lessons you'd like to see us make on this channel. We'd love to hear what stuff you guys would like to learn. If you'd like to learn more, don't forget to check out licklibrary.com. There's a huge library of great lesson content to take your playing to that next level and help you improve. Don't forget to check out the other videos in this series where we look at the guitar styles and habits of Dave Murray and Yannick Gers from Iron Maiden. The links for those are down below in the description as well. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. keep up to date with all the content here at Licklibrary. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys very soon.